The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... I'm E.G. Marshall, your host for another visit to that curious world where curious things happen to remind us that we live in a strange, strange world, particularly when it's the world of our own imagination. Jody Barnes, the hero of our tale, wasn't imagining things when success was dangled in front of him by a high-powered press agent. Jody was a singer of country and rock music. Small time, small dates, but he had talent. What he needed was a gimmick. And one day, a man walked into his life with just that gimmick. Jody was on his way to the top, but something nagged at him. Something he couldn't put his finger on.
What's the matter, Jody?
Just tired, I guess. Too much, too fast.
It's what we've dreamed about.
Craig's doing what he said he'd do, building me into a star. But it's all happening too soon. Instant success. It's unreal.
But what's to be scared of? You're good, and you know it. And everybody else knows it.
Oh, I'm not afraid of singing or whether they like me. That's not it, Lisa. I'm scared of this big balloon that's blowing up. This big press agent's dream. It looms ahead of me and it scares me.
Our mystery drama, Graven Image, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Bob Juran and stars Jack Grimes. It is sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, and Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Somewhere deep down inside us all is a little spark of hope that one day we'll be famous and rich. In some, the spark slowly dies as the years pass. But in others, the spark flares up, fanned by help from an unexpected source. And sudden fame and fortune are theirs. Such was the case with Jody Barnes, who in less than a year rose from an unknown country rock singer to the top of the charts. In fact, in just a few short hours, his loyal fans will fill New York City's Madison Square Garden for a sold-out concert. But at this moment, Jody's wife, Lisa, and his manager, Craig Herbert, are desperately trying to find him.
The sergeant, everybody knows what Jody Barnes looks like. Can't you put out an all points or whatever you do? Well, I got $1 million riding on this concert. Yeah. Yeah, thanks. I'm in this dressing room at the garden. You can reach me here. I was afraid something like this had happened.
So was I. I told you this concert was too soon after his...
Breakdown. Yeah, I know. But he's got to stay in the spotlight. He's had a long enough rest. He's number one, and he's going to stay there.
I'm not so sure anymore.
Well, I am. 3 hours left. Damn. Get on the phone and call anywhere he's likely to go. I'll get a cab and take to the streets. Someone's bound to spot him.
I'll keep calling the apartment, too, in case he might have gotten past the doorman.
Okay, let's move. In 3 hours, we're going to have a screaming, stamping mob out there. And if Jody doesn't show, I don't want to be the one to tell him.
I know they're looking for me. I was supposed to do a concert tonight. But that's out of the question now. I'm sitting right here in our apartment. But they won't find me. The phone seems so far away. I couldn't reach it if I wanted to. And I don't want to. I'm not going to do that concert tonight. or any more concerts or records. There isn't any Jody Barnes anymore. That's why they can't find me. I'm just not anymore. There isn't any me. No real Jody Barnes. There was once, though. I came out of San Jose, California a little more than a year ago with a guitar on one arm and Lisa on the other. I played and sang wherever I could. Street corners, gin mills. I never made much money or much of a mark, but Lisa and I were happy. Until it all began at the county fair.
Hiya, kid.
Huh?
Hey, got a minute?
But what do you want?
A little talk.
Huh?
I like your style. Here's my card. Craig Herbert, Artist Management. I'm from New York. I travel around to shows like these. I like to pick up a young budding talent when I see it and do something with it.
Well, I'm doing okay now, thanks. I don't
know.
Now,
wait a minute, Jordy. Let's talk. How long you been playing these back roads?
2 years.
And 4 months.
Well, don't you want to move up?
I'm happy.
Ever been to Las Vegas?
Pass through.
You could be playing any hotel there that you wanted. Chicago, New York, Records.
Mr. Herbert.
Craig, honey. Call me Craig.
You mean you want to manage Jody? Get him bookings in places like that?
More than that. Much more. I could put Jody Barnes on the top of the charts in 1 year.
Look, I may be young, but I'm dry behind the ears. What's your angle?
You mean, why do I come into a two-bit fair and offer an unknown string plucker a chance at something big?
Yeah.
Because I want someone fresh, totally unknown, to prove my theory that I can make him a star. And you got the stuff. You play and sing as good as any of them. What you need is a manager and a gimmick. Now, look, this is no place to talk business. Can I meet you tonight after your last show? When you can relax?
Well, we can talk, I guess.
I know I sounded far out this afternoon, but believe me, I'm on the level.
We're willing to listen.
Listen.
Okay. Now look, who really sings nowadays anyway? A handful of real talent. The rest are selling out the houses with gimmicks and publicity. The public goes wild over them because they're told to.
Now, you're saying you can sell me with a gimmick instead of my talent?
No, Jody. You have got talent. But there's another side of the coin. The public's got to know about you. First, we make your name a household word. Then they come because you're in.
Okay, I'm not dumb enough to say I don't want success, but what's the percentage in all of this?
An honest deal. A 5-year contract. Me, your exclusive manager and agent, for 20% of your gross from all enterprises.
Enterprises?
Well, I got plans for more than just appearances and records. I said we're going to make your name a household word.
But it sure sounds exciting, Jody.
Okay, Craig, I'll tell you what. You draw up your contract, and in the meantime, I'll do some thinking, and Lisa and me will do some talking about it. Maybe we can work out a deal.
I'll have a contract by the end of the week. Where are you booked after the fair?
Well, I got nothing lined up. I was heading back to San Jose.
Okay. I'll meet you Saturday, and we'll go over the whole thing.
We'll think on it.
Just think of your name on one of those Vegas marquees. A store window full of your records.
You make it sound like a dream come true. You still awake, Jody?
Yeah.
We're both lying here thinking the same thing, I'll bet, about what Craig Herbert said.
Yeah. That'd be nice to be up there where the lights are shining on me. It'd make Dad proud. We'd never have to worry about money. You could have everything you want.
Well, I just want you to be a success, Jody, because I know you're good.
Well, we haven't got anything to lose. All I have to do is sing. I'll have to see what the terms of the contract are.
Jody?
Huh?
You don't think you're being taken in, do you?
Well, I don't know, but I can handle myself.
I'm glad you wanted to go over the contract carefully, Jody. You can see I'm on the level.
Okay, I think we got a deal. If you can put me on the top of the charts in a year, you'll earn your 20%.
All right, here's what I want you to do. Go back home, write a couple of new songs. Your act's too short. Work up an hour and a half. First thing we got to do is cut an album.
Well, we'll go to my dad's farm in San Jose. We were planning to go there after this job anyway.
Good. And rest up. Because when I come back for you, you're going to be one busy kid.
Shouldn't you be inside writing those songs, Judy?
Oh, the last one's finished, Dad. Here in my head, anyway.
You think that fellow's going to call you? It's been 3 weeks.
Nah, I know he will. What do you have to gain by just giving me a line and then forgetting the whole thing?
Well, Jody, here's your home. Always will be. Just stay on or come back to.
I know that, Dad. You know, I'm fired up over this now. I wasn't at first, I'll admit. I was skeptical. But that agent's got me thinking straight. Why can't I be as big as the rest of them?
Is that what you really want? To be as big as the rest of them?
Well, every guy wants to be the best he can.
I won't argue that's good thinking. But being the best you can and being big, well, they're kind of different to me.
Oh, you know what I mean, Dad.
Jody!
I think I do, son. But just watch where you're stepping.
Jody!
Hey, Lisa's waving.
Jody, phone. It's Craig Herbert. He wants us to meet him in Los Angeles on Monday. You know, it's been 2 years since we've been in L.A.
Sure. Our honeymoon.
Funny how people come thousands of miles to visit here, and we're only up the coast, and we haven't been here in 2 years. Jody,
huh?
Stop the car. Look.
What is it?
That orange sticker on the telephone pole.
Well, I'll be.
It's your name. Jody Barnes, the one to watch.
It's got to be that Craig Herbert's doing.
Well, he's getting your name around. There's another one.
Hey, how about that? My name on a mailbox.
Well, that was the start of it all. My name was on almost every lamppost in L.A. I cut an album for a small record company, and Craig got me a booking in a little place on the Strip. The night I opened, every ashtray in the place had a picture of me on it. I went over pretty good, and the booking started getting better.
They're asking for you now, Jody boy, and that's what we want. Phil Brody called me today.
Phil Brody?
Yeah, the producer of the Jerry Maxwell Show, the top-rated late-night talk show on network TV. They want you for an appearance March 18th.
Hey, that's great. I'll have to let Dad know.
And what timing? It's just 1 week before the start of your tour. And have I got a gimmick for that tour? I'll show it to you Saturday. Well, what do you think?
It's super.
Me? On a T-shirt?
Not a bad likeness, considering it's on cloth. It's costing a bundle, but for $5,000, we're getting $1 million in publicity. You see, I'm passing these out. 500 of these in every town on the tour. Anybody wearing a Jody Barnes T-shirt to your show gets in for half price.
I think it's cute.
Well, it's a gimmick, all right.
The kids will wear them to school all over town. And everyone at each show gets your album free. We're going to leave a trail of Jody Barnes clear across the country.
What's the matter, Jody?
Oh, just tired, I guess. Too much, too fast. I'm scared to death of this tour, Lisa.
What's to be scared of? You're good and you know it. And everybody else knows it.
Oh, I'm not afraid of singing or whether they like me. That's not it, Lisa. I'm scared of this big balloon that's blowing up. This big press agent's dream. It looms ahead of me and it scares me stiff.
Jody Barnes seems a bit perturbed by the exciting career. curious that a healthy young man with nothing but success should be afraid of it. But maybe, as Jody said, it's too much too fast. Some things take getting used to. But that balloon looming ahead is going to get bigger and bigger. Things move faster and faster for Jody Barnes, as you will see when I return with Act Two. Almost everyone dreams of success, but success demands its price. Hard work, little private life. And thus it is for Jody Barnes, launching on a cross-country tour, still relatively unknown. There's hard, exhausting work ahead, more than he counted on, with his manager, Craig Herbert, calling the plays. In his promise to put Jody on top.
I can't cancel Harrisburg.
I'm exhausted, Craig. I've got to have a break. 25 one-nighters in 30 days.
Okay. Look, we've got to play Harrisburg. It's too big to miss.
Oh.
I'll cancel Atlantic City, and we'll head straight into New York.
I'm not used to it, that's all.
You'll have to get used to it, Jody. You're catching on. The last three stops were sellouts. But don't expect New York City to be waiting for you with open arms. We still got to push.
What did you book in New York?
The Skylight Lounge. Not the biggest, but it's the Big Apple.
You know, more traveling for a while.
It's been paying off, though. By the end of the year, you're going to be king of the hill.
And he was right. I cut a new album with orchestral arrangements, and it sold a million in 2 months. We picked up another guitar, bass, and drums for the live act, and the crowd couldn't seem to get enough of me. And for a while, I began to relax. I'd made it. And that's when Craig decided to branch out.
Jody Barnes Enterprises. I got it all drawn up legal. You're a corporation.
I don't want to get involved in all that stuff, Craig. I just want to sing.
Oh, don't worry. I'll handle this end. But there's lots of advantages, tax-wise, for one. And I got a gimmick that'll make us a fortune.
We're making that now.
Nothing to what we'll make with the toy company.
A toy company?
Yeah, Miller Toys wants to bring out a Jody Barnes board game. You know, like all the TV shows have. They're working on it now.
Oh, come on, Craig. What is all this?
This is business, Jody boy. Your name's hot stuff. The kids will be taking their lunch to school in Jody Barnes lunchboxes. We'll come out with the Jody Barnes hair dryer. And I have got the idea that tops them all. It's inspired. The kids will buy them faster than your records.
What, for heaven's sake?
The Jody Barnes talking doll.
Doll?
I can get Miller to manufacture them. An exact likeness of you, only about 10 inches high, with your voice on tape. You know what I mean? Those dolls that talk on tape when you pull the string? Only this one will be battery operated. You push a button, and there's Jody Barnes talking and singing to you. Great, huh? Great?
Sounds sick to me. Who'd want one of those things?
Everybody. I'm talking to Miller this week about the design, and then you'll have to tape the lines. I don't know what yet, but stuff like, Hi, I'm Jody Barnes. Have you got my new record? Stuff like that.
It's so silly, Craig. I don't want to do it.
Listen, I'm handling the business end, right? You just go along with my ideas and stick to your singing. We'll both be able to retire in 2 years.
I think the doll's a great idea.
And so will every teenage girl in the country. Now, just leave it to me, Jody boy. Leave it all to me. Jody, Lisa, open up.
Hi, Craig.
I got it. Right here under my arm.
The doll.
Will you see it? You won't believe it.
Well, I still don't think anyone's going to buy one.
You'll change your mind when you see it. Yeah, there.
Oh, Jody, it's beautiful.
Isn't that a likeness? They got your face perfect. The slant of your nose, the eyes.
It's so real.
Now, watch.
Hello, I'm Jody Barnes. I'm singing just for you.
Oh, Craig, the that's wonderful.
Isn't that something?
I hate it.
Jody?
It's grotesque, silly.
All right. Now, calm down, Jody boy. Miller's got 500,000 of them on the way. We can't stop now.
Craig, I can't tell you how I feel. I just... I hate it.
Oh, Jody, let Craig go ahead with it. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, but it's so cheap. All of a sudden, I'm turning into nothing but a gimmick. A board game, a lunchbox, a
dollar. It's business, Jody, and the fans love it. Otherwise, they wouldn't buy the stuff.
I think Craig's right. I want what you want, but these things can't hurt you or your image.
Oh, go ahead. What's the difference? I'm going for a walk.
Oh, come on, Jody. What's the matter? We never had words like this before. What's eating them, Lisa?
I don't know. It's hard for us to understand. It isn't our face on the lunchboxes and T-shirts or this doll. It's Jody's. It's a lot more personal for him.
Well, he's right. I don't understand. I thought he'd want all the extra publicity and money these kinds of things bring.
Jody's a simple guy. All this is too much for him. It's been a strain on me, too.
Lisa, maybe you can talk to him. Let him see what I'm trying to do.
I can only be there when he wants me, Craig. I did side with you earlier, but I don't want to put more pressure on him. I'm his wife.
Yeah, you're right. He'll be okay. When he sees how popular these things are going to be, he'll change his attitude. Won't you, Jody?
Hello. I'm Jody Barnes. I'm singing just for you.
Jody?
I'm back.
Jody, I was so worried. Where have you been?
The park. Walking and thinking. I'm sorry. I should have known you'd be worried.
Feel better?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess I'm making too much of this whole thing, but I have this strange feeling as though I was slipping away from myself.
Maybe you ought to see a doctor, Jody.
A shrink, you mean?
No, a regular doctor. Well, maybe there's something physically wrong.
Oh, that'll be okay.
I wish you'd think about seeing a doctor. Oh, I'll get it. Hello?
Lisa, is he back yet?
Yes, he is. Hold on. It's Craig.
Okay. Hello?
Jody, listen. If you're this upset about the doll, we'll rethink it. Your singing is the important thing. I don't want to upset that. Get you all strung out so you can't sing. We got that tour starting the 8th.
Go ahead with the doll. I don't care. I'm more anxious to start rehearsing with the new drummer. We've only got 2 weeks before Chicago.
I'll get the Temple Studios boat starting on Wednesday.
Oh, good, good.
Someone here wants to say hello to you.
Who?
Hello. I'm Jody Barnes. I'm singing just for you.
Great show tonight, Jody.
That was lousy. That drummer's got to go. He's too fast. I told him that since we started rehearsing.
Well, it sounded fine to me.
I'm doing the singing, and it sounded lousy.
Well, we can't break in a new guy before St. Louis. I'll talk to him.
It won't do any good.
We'll see. Want to get a pizza on the way to the hotel?
No. I'm going right to bed. I have to call Lisa.
She's still meeting us in St. Louis?
Yeah, as far as I know.
Okay, I'll see you later. I got to check some things with the theater manager. Relax, Jody.
I haven't done that for a year.
You will.
Look, leave the door open, huh? This dressing room's like a tomb.
Okay, I'll see you back at the hotel.
Wait a few minutes more. Maybe some of the street crowd will leave. Oh, Lord, I'm tired.
Hello. Huh? I'm Jody Barnes. I'm singing just for you.
Surprise, Mr. Barnes. I thought you'd be pleased.
Get that thing out of here.
Oh, Mr. Barnes, I didn't mean to...
If I hear those damn words again, I'll... Give me that doll.
Mr. Barnes!
Give it to me, I said. Look, I'm sorry. I'll pay you for it. I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry. I waited till the crowd left. I wanted to surprise you.
Thanks.
I'm Annette. I didn't know you didn't like the doll.
Can't stand the things, but tell me, do you like the doll?
Oh, sure.
Why? Doesn't it seem... Isn't it grotesque to have that painted, lifeless thing talking and singing?
Oh, we all think it's way out. And I've got an ashtray with your picture on it, a T-shirt, my brother has a Jody Barnes lunchbox, my sister has a hairdryer, and everybody has the game.
Then you and your friends like all these gimmicks. You don't think less of me.
These things are you, Mr. Barnes. I never really thought of you as a person. Jody, do you think you ought to go on tonight?
Sure. Why not? I'm going to tear the place apart.
Oh, what a house, Jody. St. Louis is yours.
I got to tell Frank to keep up the tempo. Tempo, got to keep him off his seats. Well, we're going to kill him tonight.
It's a sea of T-shirts you're singing to, Jody.
Look, I got to get up on the stage. I'll see you later, huh? Kill him tonight.
Craig, I'm scared to death. What's the matter with Jody?
Nothing.
Oh, come on, Craig. He's a different man. What's happened to him on this tour?
Well, he's getting with it. He's lost his hang-ups.
He's losing his mind. He doesn't belong out there tonight.
Lay off it, will you, Lisa? He's okay. Now, come on. We'll watch him from the wings.
Something's the matter with him, Craig. Look at him.
Oh, he's okay.
Why isn't he singing? He's just staring at the audience.
He's got him in the palm of his hand. He's teasing.
No, he's never done this before. He's always... Craig, he's staggering.
Yeah, you're right. Something is wrong.
Oh, he's collapsed. Craig, get him.
Curtain! Get that curtain down!
Saw it.
The doctor's on his way, Jody.
I just saw it.
He's soaking wet.
It was there, and I was there.
Easy, Jody. Don't talk.
I saw me through its eyes, and then I wasn't there. Where am I?
In the hospital.
Hospital? Why?
You collapsed.
Oh. I remember. Something happened.
What happened, Jody?
I was singing out there, and then I saw it. In the front row, a kid had one of those dolls.
Oh, lots of them, probably.
And all of a sudden, I was seeing the stage from the house. All of a sudden, I was sitting in this kid's lap, watching the stage.
Oh, Jody.
I was, Lisa. I was looking at the stage from the front row. And on the stage, I wasn't there.
Tension, overwork, worry, fear can cause the mind to create strange and frightening images. But for Jody Barnes, the graven images were all around him. Everywhere he looked, he saw an image of himself on T-shirts, lunchboxes, and the dolls. Yes, the dolls. They began to look back at him, and with curious results, as we'll see when I return shortly with Act 3. Was it overwork, tension, anxiety that caused Jody Barnes to collapse on stage during a performance? He saw, or he thought he saw, something profoundly disturbing. The stage through the eyes of a doll held by a girl in the audience. But then Jody Barnes hasn't been himself lately. Probably because he's becoming more and more confused about who his real self is. But his sudden collapse on stage caused quite a stir among his fans and the news media.
They're just not buying our story about overwork. The rumor mill's at full speed now. You don't know how they love to drag up all kinds of ideas.
He's got to get away for a while, Craig. The doctor ordered it. Isn't that good enough for those precious newspapers? He's taking a vacation. What's wrong with that?
For anybody else, nothing. But for Jody Barnes, a rest cure conjures up all sorts of evil ailments. When you're king of the hill, they just love nothing better than to get on your tail.
We're taking off for Dad's farm tomorrow.
I can't stop you. I can just try to cover the tracks.
He's got to get away from radio, records, the dolls, the publicity, everything.
Okay, Lisa. Okay, I understand. Keep in touch.
His father's so happy he's coming home for a while. I hope he's not shocked when he sees him.
Oh, it sure is good to be in the farmland again, away from all that.
Oh, we'll have a great time, Jody.
I wish I could forget what happened on stage.
You've got to, Jody. It was just strange.
But it was so clear. I was seeing through the eyes of that doll. I was down there looking up at me. Only I wasn't on the stage.
Oh, think about the weeks ahead, Jody. Don't think about that. We're almost to Dad.
Around the bend by the old oak tree, and we'll be home quick as can be. My mom used to sing that when I was a kid.
And there's the old oak tree up ahead.
Hey, what's going on? Something's wrong. There's a crowd in front of Dad's. Something's happened to him.
No, Jody. Dad's all right. It's a welcoming committee.
A welcoming committee?
Banners, balloons.
Keep right on driving.
Jody,
I won't get out. I'm not going out there.
Jody, they're all Dad's friends and neighbors. They're proud of you. Don't disappoint Dad.
I don't want to see any of them. I came here to get away from all that. I came home to be by myself. Why won't they let me be myself?
Well, the folks are sure proud to see you home, Jody. I guess they roughed you up a little, but we're all so proud. I've known here now as Jody Barnes' dad.
That's nice.
And I bet you're ready for a good hot tub and some of my special private stock, huh? I'll just get it out and we'll have a celebration. I got a surprise for you.
Jody, I'm glad you didn't disappoint him. They all look forward to that celebration. I'm glad you got out and talked to them.
Well, even here, I can't get away from it. I should have gone to a desert island.
Oh, this week will be better. You'll see. I'll go up and run a tub for you. You relax and have your drink with Dad.
Yeah, okay, honey.
I'll call you when it's ready.
Dad?
You're right there. Just getting my surprise.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, now, just close your eyes.
Oh, come on, Dad.
Got them closed.
Yes?
Hello? I'm Jody Barnes.
No.
I'm singing for you.
Jody.
Just take it away.
Jody, what's the matter?
Get it away.
Well, I don't see what
get it out of here.
Matter? What is it, Dad?
Get it away.
I don't know.
Get it away.
Take it easy, son.
Get it out of here.
Oh, Dad, the doll. He hates them.
Yeah, but I thought... Well, I mean, everybody has them. I'll just put it in the kitchen cupboard. I had no idea he felt that way.
Jody, relax.
Okay, it was... Oh, man, it was so sudden. I didn't expect it.
Come on upstairs. Your bath's running. You've got to calm down.
I thought I'd gotten away from those things.
I'll see you all in a little while. I've got a few chores to do.
Go on up, Jody.
I thought he'd be pleased.
Dad, I know you're hurt, but there are some things you've got to know.
What have they done to Jody, Lisa? What's happened to my boy? Feel like driving over to Carterville?
No.
Just soon sit?
Yeah.
What's eating you, son?
Dad, I feel like a shell, like a nothing. Can you understand? I'm a top-rated singer in the business today, and I'm a nothing. I'm a lunchbox, a T-shirt, a record album, you name it.
Lunchbox?
I'm not Jody Barnes anymore. I belong to every kid who buys a record or a ticket. I'm strung out across the country with my face on billboards, outhouses. There's a great big image they call Jody Barnes, but there isn't any Jody Barnes. And you know who told me? A kid. A kid came backstage in Omaha and told me about all the junk she's collected with my picture on. And she said, I never thought of you as a person.
No, you shouldn't let that get inside you, Jody. Every famous person has to take some of that.
I'm empty inside. Well, I'm going to get some lemonade. Do you want some, Dad?
No, I'll get it.
No, you sit still.
Glasses are in the cupboard on the left.
Okay.
Oh, staring at me from the shelf of the cabinet was the doll. The horrible painted face, my face, looking at me. I stood there swaying, grabbing the kitchen counter for support. Suddenly, I was sitting on the cupboard shelf, looking out into the kitchen. I didn't know whether I was me looking at the doll or whether I was the doll looking at me.
Jody, what happened? Jody, what's the matter? Jody?
I just felt dizzy for a second.
You want me to call Doc Mason?
No. I'll be okay.
Craig must be out of his mind if he thinks he can schedule a concert at Madison Square Garden. And you agree.
I've got to go back, Lisa. I've got to try that concert.
You can't, Jody.
I got to fight this thing. I'm letting a doll take over my life. I've got to go back and be Jody Barnes. I've let myself be pulled inside out. I'll never stop till I face it.
Do you think you can face it?
I've got to. I told Craig I'd do the concert. Rehearsals start in 2 weeks.
I can't stop you, but I think it's too soon.
No. It's almost too late. I can't run away from it anymore. I feel as though I'm being drawn back. We'll leave for New York at the end of the week.
Hey, Jody, boy, you're looking fine. Country air did wonders, huh?
Yeah, I'm okay, Craig.
You too, Lisa. You both look great.
I hope we stay that way.
Well, you're back in New York now, back in the saddle. And will you see the publicity on a Garden concert? We expect a sellout the day the tickets go on sale.
Oh, good.
That's a boy. That's talking like a professional.
Well, I don't have anything to be afraid of anymore.
Good. You get rehearsing tomorrow, and we're going to rock that garden like it's never been rocked before.
Jody?
Hmm?
Are you as relaxed as you seem?
Well, I'm not fighting anymore. Can you believe it, Lisa? I found a sort of peace. I'm not fighting to keep my identity. I'm giving in. And it's peaceful.
After this concert, Jody, why don't we buy that farm down the way from Dad and start a family?
Yeah, tomorrow's concert. I don't want to think about tomorrow or the next day. I don't want to think much anymore at all. Good night, honey.
Night. See you in the morning.
I wonder.
Huh?
Good night.
Lisa, any luck?
I've been on the phone since you left. No one's seen him.
An hour and a half. They're starting to fill the house. Where the hell can he have gotten to?
Something's happened to him. I know it. An accident.
No. If he'd been in an accident, he'd be recognized and we'd have known. No, I think he might have gone off his rocker again.
He didn't go off his rocker.
Try the apartment once more.
He's not there. What's the use?
All right, I'll do it. There's always a chance.
There they go again. Phoning to see if I'm here. I'm never going to answer a phone again. It's kind of nice to know that. It's peaceful. And it's so nice to know who I am at last.
They're going to have to know. Thank God I'm not the one who has to go out there.
I don't give a damn about the crowd. I'm sick about Jody.
Well, don't you think I am? But we've done everything we can short of the FBI.
Well, I'm still counting on him to show up, even if it's the last minute.
I'm going to have to huddle with the promoters. Ooh, I'm going to be in a sling over this. You want to go home?
Not on your life. I'm staying.
I guess they'll be coming back to the apartment soon. I wonder what the crowd thought when Jody Barnes didn't appear. I sort of hated to disappoint them. But then it couldn't be helped, I guess. Wait. I think I hear Craig and Lisa.
Jody?
Ah, you didn't expect to find him here, did you, Lisa?
I didn't know what to expect.
Well, one thing. We're lucky they didn't tear up the seats back there. I've never seen an uglier mob.
Craig, look.
What?
Jody must have come back here. One of the dolls is there on the couch. I know it wasn't there when I left the apartment.
Why would he bring one home? I thought he hated the things. He thought they were taking over his life.
He does. Oh, I don't understand. Give it to me.
Hello, I'm Jody Barnes.
Oh, Craig, where can he be?
Careful, Lisa. Don't drop me.
Craig, he spoke.
That wasn't on the tape. How can it be?
I'm Jody Barnes, and I'm happier than I've ever been.
Take it, Craig. Take it. I can't stand this.
This is the real Jody Barnes, Lisa. This is all that's left. This is the real Jody Barnes.
Jody Barnes found the peace he was drawn to. He gave up trying to fight his image, and he took the easy way out. He surrendered himself to the image of himself, one that was created for him by a well-meaning but over-enthusiastic press agent. The next time you see a T-shirt or a lunchbox, a poster, or, heaven forbid, a doll, with the likeness of some popular personality, stop and think. Is there really such a person? Or is it just an image? Think it over. And we'll compare notes when I return shortly. What do you think? Is a graven image just a harmless replica? Or can it be a power that draws the real self to it, thus leaving emptiness where the self had been? Ponderous thoughts, indeed. In any event, image is the first part of imagination, and that's what concerns us most. I hope we've teased yours with our story just concluded. Our cast included Jack Grimes, Robert Dryden, and Hetty Galen. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division and Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, brewers of Budweiser. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.